So in this video, I want to give a shout out to my blood brother, Davon. He has a YouTube channel. His YouTube channel is called DBTV. And y'all think my hair is long? No, his hair is long. His hair is probably longer than mine. So y'all go check out his content. He does hair videos. He does tech stuff. And he got some more stuff coming on the way. So yeah, make sure y'all go check out his lit content. I'm going to link his stuff in my bio. So go check that out. But besides all that, let's go ahead and get into this video. It's your girl TupacTaj back again with what's up YouTube, it's your girl TupacTaj back again with another video. And in today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys my number one go-to stretch method. Like, this is my gym, for real. Like, this was a game changer for me. Once I started doing this to my hair, people was like, dang, your hair done grew. Your hair this, your hair that. Listen, it's cause I'm stretching it, so let me put you on real quick. Why I love this stretch method is because, one, it doesn't require any heat. Now, I will say in this video, I'm gonna put a little heat on my hair just because the back of it is still wet, so I'm gonna blow dry it. But if you can air dry your hair, then this does not require heat at all. So that's one thing that I love about the stretch method. And also, not only is it my stretch method, it's also how I protect my hair at night. So I'm about to give y'all my gem for real. So without further ado, let's get into it. Okay, so as I already told y'all, I'm gonna put a little heat on the back of my hair just because it's still wet back there. So when I do this, I use a diffuser. You don't wanna just use like a regular just blow dryer without the diffuser because it's just gonna make your hair kind of frizzy. So what the diffuser does, it just kind of keeps your hair curly in place and it doesn't just make it just, you know what I'm saying? I hope that makes sense, but if it doesn't, I'm sorry. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my diffuser and I'm gonna turn it on low and warm and I'm just gonna blow dry the back of my hair. Check the back just to make sure it's nice and dry. False alarm, it's not done yet. Alright, I think we good, y'all. So my hair is nice and dry. So this method is so simple and I'm gonna show y'all. I put all my scrunchies on a perfume bottle that I don't use, so that's a life hack for y'all. But I'm gonna take some scrunchies. I'm gonna get about 6 of them. All right, y'all. So all you need for this stretch method is scrunchies. That's it, that's all. It's that simple. So you can really use regular scrunchies for this, but I like to use the scrunchies with material and I'm gonna show y'all why in a second. But I start off by parting my hair into 2 sections. And before you do this, you want to make sure your hair is completely dry, like there's no wetness at all. So I'll go ahead and part my hair into 2 sections, right? And the part doesn't have to be perfect. You just need to make sure it's parted. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my hair starting from the top and I'm just going to twist it all the way down. And make sure you get all the hair in there. If you feel like your hair is too dry when you do this, you can apply some oil to your hair just to make sure it's nice and dry. Wait, you could apply some oil to your hair just to make sure it's nice and oiled up. Hold on, let me start that over because I didn't make that tight enough. So you want it nice and tight. And you're gonna take your scrunchie and you just wrap it around like a ponytail. And make sure your hair is twisted. Now, you don't want your scrunchies to be too tight on there, but you want them on there, you know what I'm saying? Because if you put them too tight, then when you take it down, your hair is gonna look like stringy, and you don't want it to look stringy, trust me, because. So yeah, you just take some more scrunchies and you wrap it all the way down to the bottom. Well, not all the way to the bottom, but close to the bottom. So the hair at the bottom, you just leave that out. And there you go. Now, I'm gonna do it to the other side. You just take it and you twist it. The more scrunchies that you put on your hair, the more stretched out it's gonna be. So I usually do 3 scrunchies, but you know, you just go by the length of your hair and determine what you think is best for you. So I just take it, wrap it around, make sure they're not too tight. Now, the end part, make sure that you get all the hair pulled through the scrunchie, because if you leave hair up there, it's gonna look a mess when you take it down. So, there you have it, your 2 little twists. Now, after you get your scrunchies on there, you're gonna take a scarf like this. Now, it's best to use a satin scarf, but me, satin scarves tend to magically come off my head in the middle of the night. I don't know like what be happening, but that's what be happening. Me, I gotta use a regular scarf because I'm too rough when I sleep apparently. So yeah, you just take your scarf and you tie it around. And boom, there you have it. And what I like about this is I usually put a black scarf on because you can go to the grocery store with your hair like this. You can go to the gym with your hair like this and you don't look like too crazy. I mean, I don't think I do anyways. But if I do, please let me know. All right, y'all, I'm about to go take a shower and I'm gonna come back and show y'all what the end result looks like in the morning. Hey y'all, so it's the next day. I'm gonna take my hair down and show y'all what it's looking like. As y'all can see, my scarf stayed in place last night. Kudos to me, right? I know. So let's go ahead and take this down. So y'all know when I told y'all that I like to use the scrunchies that got material on it, this is why. Because it makes it so much easier to just slide off. So you just take your scrunchies off, slide them down, just like that. And you just unravel your twist. And you just separate it, just like that. And look, tell me y'all don't see the difference. Like, somebody tell me I'm tripping, cause I know I'm not crazy. Like, it's giving me very much body yaddy yaddy. It's giving me very much length. Like, yeah, it's definitely the banding method for me. So let me show y'all the other side. So yeah, you just separate your hairs and look. And if you feel like your hair isn't fluffy enough like you want it, you could take a pick and just tug at your roots with the pick. But I kind of already like how mine looks, so I'm not going to mess with it too much. And yeah, you just kind of make sure you get it, you know, mess with it until it's how you want it. And if you feel like your hair is too dry, just take some oil or maybe like some moisturizer or something and rub it on your hair. Usually what I do after I take my twist down, I do my baby hairs. But I ain't gonna mess with them too much because they already don't bleed, you know what I'm saying? Now, I'm not gonna sit here and say that this stretch method makes your hair super duper long, but it definitely, definitely makes a difference for me anyways. Like, I don't even like wearing my hair regular anymore. I like my hair so much more when it's twisted out like this. Like, I don't know, it just makes a difference to me. So I got a few more stretch methods that I wanna show you guys, but like I said, this is the main one that I like to use. And I do this every night pretty much. So like, I love that, you know, I have a way to protect my curls at night, and like my curls be lasting for days. But before this, like, I didn't know what to do with my hair at night. I would wake up in the morning, my hair would be all over my head. But now I got a way to protect this. So yeah, I definitely recommend this stretch method to anybody. Like, yeah, this is the one. That's the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did enjoy this video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and leave me a blue heart in the comments. Cause I'm trying to see some. I'm trying to see who really rocking with me. So if you really rocking with me, leave me a blue heart. And I thank you guys, and I'll see y'all in the next video.